Hello and welcome to The Teacher's Room, the show that's by teachers for teachers. I'm Dan.
And I'm Sian.
Yes, she is.
And this episode's topic is...
So you don't correct every mistake in the same way, do you?
No, think about the purpose of your activity. So if you're doing an accuracy activity, you might want to correct mistakes on the spot and do this quickly without interrupting the flow and get students to correct their own mistakes if possible.
Yeah, because that would help them to learn where the mistake was and hopefully that they don't repeat the same thing. One thing that you can do is use a visual method like using your fingers. For example, with a contraction, I might say, I would like becomes...
I'd like.
Very good, very nice. And this is also good when the student makes an error where there's a word too many in a sentence or one word missing in a sentence.
I agree. Dan, I agree.
Yes, you agree. Do. Good job.
You can also use gestures, use your hands. So like if a student makes a mistake with tense, so yesterday I go to the cinema, just show them. That means past.
Past.
Or future.
Future.
Looks like we're doing a dance.
What about if they put the words in the wrong order?
Oh, how about that? That can show, change the, don't hit me, change the word order. We study always grammar.
We always study grammar. Yes.
We always study grammar.
Because you need it.
Yeah, and if you know your class really well and you know they're not going to be offended, then you can make a joke about mistakes, particularly ones they make again and again and again. Be dramatic. What are you doing there?
I used to get my students to hit themselves. I mean, not hard, but when they made the same mistake 3 or 4 times in the same day, I'd say, that's it. Give yourself a slap.
You've made lots of mistakes today, Dan. Your face is going red.
And don't forget that also if you have a good relationship with your class, it's a perfect opportunity to get them to peer correct each other. They can watch each other's backs and support each other in the learning process.
<Too bad.
laughs> Teacher, my father is a strong smoker.
Your father is a strong smoker? Mm. Anybody? My father is a...
Heavy!
Ah, heavy. My father is a heavy smoker.
Very good.
Thank you, Mario.
So would you correct all errors the same way then?
No, so if you're doing a fluency activity, you don't want to interrupt the flow, break the concentration.
Break the energy in the room, I see, Okay.
I tell students, I'm just going to listen, I'm going to write down, pen the right way, I'm going to write down some errors or language and deal with it at the end.
Ah, so then afterwards you might use them for an activity like a game or a roundup.
Play a game like a grammar auction.
Yeah, or hunt the mistake.
Yes.
Or you can set them for homework. I used to give them 10 sentences. These are the 10 biggest mistakes the class made today as a whole. Take them home and correct them as best you can.
Wow, that's a lot of homework.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Huh?
So they're slapping themselves, they're doing lots of homework. Yeah,
but you've got to praise them too. You've got to say, hey, that was a good example of language. I heard that, that was fantastic. You should also give them the stick as well as the carrot or the other way around.
You've been really good today, Dan. Well done.
Thank you very much. Okay, class, good speaking activity. Well done, everybody. While you were talking, I was listening and taking notes. On the board, I have put 3 pieces of language which you all said. I would like to know which one of these sentences is correct, which 2 are wrong, and why are they wrong? With a partner, go. Now, the tips we've mentioned are only our ideas.
And we know that you have lots of great ideas that you can share with us.
Over the series, we'll be giving away some of these fantastic t-shirts, and we know you want them, and one of them could be yours.
Yes, so to find out how to get one of these lovely t-shirts.
And to get featured on our show.
Yeah, you have to send us a tip.
Yeah.
Go to our website, bbclearningenglish.com. Ah, that's enough mistakes for one day.
Done. Do you want to hit me one more time, just for the camera? Ow! Bye!
See ya. That was fun.
If they did the same mistake over and over and over again.
Did the same mistake?
Me? Did I? Ow!
Made the same mistake. You've made a mistake, Dan.
Did I?
Again and again and again. Slap yourself. Is that how you do it?
Yeah. We have to do that again. It means I have to slap myself again. Again and again. I'd be like, hit yourself.
Show me. How did you do this?
Like that.
Show me again. I don't think we got it on camera.
It's not much fun.
Your face is going red. Yeah.
How many times is that now? 5?
Okay. No more hitting yourself.
Made the same mistake over and over again.
Or each other.
Or each other. Ouch! Not in the eye!
No, you don't want to interrupt the flow, break the concentration. Sorry.
If only you knew how difficult this was. Do you want to hit me one more time for fun? Yeah! You could have said no, you know.